What we have covered is difference between GATE-CH, GATE-CHA and GATE-CHAR. I'll open another project exclusively for explaining differences between these three functions and use of these functions. I'll go step by step. I'll declare one variable as a CH, right? Let's start from the basics. If we want to store something from the keyboard, want to store something, right? What we are doing? Enter any character, right? And we used to scanf that. We used to write %c, right? We used to send the address of that. You entered %c. So user will enter. Listen carefully, watch carefully. You can ask me questions. No problem. Okay. I have written a program which we wrote long back, almost in the first chapter. Okay. That is the beauty of C language. You never know when you need to go to the back. Right? To understand again basics. So, because a lot of intricacies are there, a lot of hidden features are there. Now, basically we use the scanf function. I don't think this is, I need to run this program, but I will run. So enter any character, I will enter C, right? Now, see the operation, you can visualize that. The message is enter any character, scanf, we have called the scanf function. Inside scanf function, we have written the %c as a format specifier. Since we have written the %c, whether any format specifier, it is expecting a single character. Okay, so I have entered single character. But unless and until I press the enter key, that entered character, that is the C will not be stored in the variable ch. Am I right? Okay. So I press the enter key and it gives the message you entered C. Okay. I think this is okay for you. This is fine for you. Right. Now next. We'll continue along with this. Enter any character as T and scanf is the formatted input function. Okay, you can send the format specifier, right? But there is another category which is called unformatted functions, unformatted input function. And in that unformatted input function, exclusively for character, scanf can be used for character input, integer input, float input, double input, anything, right? Or a string as well, %s. That's why it's called a formatted input function. That F stands for formatted. Scan from the keyboard. What? Formatted input. That's why that F has been taken from the word formatted. Now, another category is unformatted. But unformatted functions are available only for the string and character. String and character. GATE-S, we have used that function in the string manipulation chapter. GATE-S was the unformatted input function exclusively for the string. That's why GATE-S, GATE string. Okay. But we were not writing format specifier like %s over there. We were sending only name of the string inside the pair of brackets, if you can recall. The GATE-S was the string input function. Similarly, there are three character input functions which are unformatted. One is GATE-CH. Another is get CHE, and third is get care. Its internal operation are very important to understand, particularly get care. Now get CH. Okay. Now here, this C here, enter any character, I will write get CH. Right? Now I'll write get CH. Right. Now, getCH function doesn't take any argument, but it returns whatever has been input. So I will store it in a character variable. I'll write CH is equal to getCH. Right. Now see the sequence of operation, how it is executed carefully. Okay, I'm giving you like omitting. This is the first printf function, okay, executed, which has been executed, and prompt is there for scanf function. So what is the sequence? Enter character or any character, and you have to press the enter key. So I'll press the enter key, right? And it gives the message you entered. So this statement has been executed now. Okay, this statement. Now the control is the second, the printf enter any character again has been. Now here get CH is there. Now observe the operations. Okay, the moment I hit the key, I will again enter C because you cannot see what I am actually typing here. I am pressing the key, not C, I will press the key P. What happened? The moment I hit the key P, that was not accepted. That was not printed on the console. But the next printf statement was immediately executed. That is the get CH. Okay. Very same moment. Okay, so what is the get CH? It just accepts one single key press, that's it, right? And it returns to that variable. So what happens when you, when I press any key, okay, when I press P, that P was stored in CH and immediately this was executed. That is get CH. Okay, now second category. These three, though they are there, there is intention for that, right? There is a meaning, there is substance in that difference. Now I am writing get CH E, right? Now again, see chronologically, see the differences, try to understand the differences. Again, I will execute the code right from the beginning, okay? And I will give you like commentary. Okay, first enter any character. I will enter A, right? Nothing has happened. A is there on the console. Unless I press the enter key, nothing is going to happen. So this is going to wait forever, lifetime it will wait for us. Okay, I press the enter key, right? You have entered A, right? That was a formatted input function for the character. Now next, enter any character. Here get CH is working. Get CH, the moment I press B, right, that is not going to be coming, that is not going to come on the console. B is not, will not be printed on the console, but next printf statement will be executed. Why? Because that whatever key I have pressed, it will be stored in the left hand side variable CH. And that we are going to print. So I'm entering B. You entered B, right? And here now this is get CHE. See here what happens. I am pressing now C. What happened? When I press C, C is there, and then next printf is executed. So this C is what get character and echo it back. Echo. Okay. It echoes back to the console. That is get CHE. Right. So get CHE. And next is get char. Again, same process. Again, like commentary. I am not getting bored. I enjoy this. I mean, I have enjoyed this and took too many efforts to, you know, understand this way back. Maybe. Because these are not, this cannot be explained in the book in a textual manner. So enter any character. I will go on sequentially. A, B, C, D. Okay. I will enter A. I have to press enter key. Now I will enter B. But B will not be here. Why? Because get CH function is in the work. So B will not be there. B will be stored only in the CH. And next printf statement will be there. So I will enter B. B doesn't appear. Now I will enter C. Right? But get CH is there. So C will be echoed back. At the same time, next printf function will be executed. Let's see. Right? And enter any character. Okay, that didn't work only because buffer was there. Earlier buffer was there. I have explained on this. Okay. So if flush function needs to be called, I will send the argument as stdin, right? So what does it mean? The earlier enter key was in the buffer, so that was assigned to that ch, right? So enter any character. A, B, B was not printed. C was echoed, and then it statement was message was there. And here now D, right? Now D, see how it works. It works like a scanf. I will have to enter D, right? But nothing will happen. This is not echoed. Right? I will have to press the enter key. Then it will print the enter. So this is how they work. I will share this listing along with you. Right? Write a file. Write a file character by character, right? So enter a few lines of text. Now I will write ch is equal to file ch, both way can be written. Okay, simple I will show you, difficult I will show you afterwards, right? Ch is equal to get char, right? if ch is equal to f e o f because while one loop I written somewhere it has to be broken, and f put c, you know, it takes argument as int and file star. Int is a, it is as well as carry, you can declare this as a int, I told you, okay. So ch, what is to be written, and name of the file pointer, internal pointer, internal name of the file, that is fptr. I need to close the file and send the pointer. If fptr equal to null, file cannot be created, right? Many students forget to handle this if block. I mean, they forget that. Okay. Exit one. Right. Now I will run this code. This is complex mechanism. Okay, I'll write some message. If suppose sim concepts or programs. This is a message for you. I'm trying to write. This is the right chapter to give you some messages. If some concepts or a program seem difficult, to understand. Or understand or implement, there is usually no value in staying up there. Wasting your time. Staying awake throughout the night intentionally. I am writing this. There is an intention, and staring at it. Take a break. Go for a walk. have snacks. Read the most. Talk about your problems or worries along with your teacher or friend. Get fresh or have sleep. Come back later and you will find that problem was not too big. What was needed was patience. Intentionally I wrote this. Okay, so what I have message wanted to give is, many times you will come across while writing programs, okay, any programming language, you will be frustrated, you cannot find the solution. Okay, aisa ho jayega, bahut bar aisa ho jayega. So better time, shut down the machine, go for a walk, have snacks, enjoy along with your friends. Okay, with fresh mind come back to the program, you will solve it within a matter of. So it may happen that problem you may stuck for hours. Okay, the next time you log in to the machine, okay, you will solve it within 5 or 10 minutes. That is my own experience. That is the experience of many programmers around the world. Now that message is intentionally written here. Just imagine now, okay, is there any string? No, there is no string here. There is no string. I have not declared any array. Okay, but only single character variable and getChar function, and that's why I wasted too much time on getChar. But how did it take this much string? That is first question. Second thing, I told you, the moment enter key is hit, right? Until that moment, getChar doesn't work. Okay, getChar doesn't work, and I have not entered. I have entered an enter key, but that still we are inside the loop. We are inside the loop. So Riju, you are going to tell me tomorrow how the getChar function works, right? If not, I will explain you in detail. That is a magical function, right? I press the enter key, and I have to end the file character. So it is Control Z or Control D. Okay, so Control Z I am pressing. That's it. Okay, so when I press the Control Z, file is saved on the hard disk. Right? Let's see. Let's go there, open the folder, current folder. Where is that file? File handling. What was the name given? Write the file. Message file is created. This whole file is there. Okay, whole file is there. Here, this, the cursor where it is blinking, that is end of file character. How to recognize that? You cannot move this arrow, move this cursor with cursor navigational keys. You have to press the enter key, but that up down arrow keys you cannot. Okay, down arrow key doesn't work here. Forward arrow doesn't work here. Whenever it doesn't work, you as a programmer can come to the conclusion that that is the end of file character, right? So we have written the file successfully. Number of lines we have written, that is the first major step, first major victory. Okay, Riju, you might have written programs using file handling, but I don't know how far you understood that everything. You might have understood, but Shivaji, this is the first major victory, first milestone, first step towards file handling. We have entered from the keyboard, we have stored successfully data in a file, right? So we will stop here.